Governor Jon Huntsman. Pat, thank you for that great introduction. I am honored and humbled to be here. Let me tell you at the very beginning, my grandfather was a school teacher. He thought that everyone should be an educator, anyone who was worth their salt. He used to teach his three sons that if you want to succeed in life, if you want to achieve anything worth achieving, you become not a teacher but an educator. That was the term he used. He was a principal of a high school in Los Altos, California. And he said, if you can't cut it as an educator, you're always going to need a fallback position in life. You can always go into business. My dad went into business. He didn't cut it as an educator. He did okay in business. I got the same darn lecture from my dad growing up. Son, if you want to make anything of your life growing up, you got to go into business. That's where you can make things, create value, and change the world. But not everybody's cut out for business, and you're going to have a fallback position in life if you can't cut it there. You can always go into politics. That's a long way, Pat, of saying I'm the loser of an educator. The Huntsman family started out with noble intentions, but here we are. And we are honored and delighted to be with you in Florida. Now, when I arrived yesterday, I was called a radical. Now, I've been called a lot of things. I've got seven kids, and when you've got seven kids, you're used to being called all kinds of things. And when people say, gee, should we call you ambassador or governor, I say, since I've been called everything, you can call me anything. I'm used to it. But I was called a radical yesterday by the Florida Democratic Party. Because I believe in balancing the budget. And I believe in the Ryan plan. So all I can say is guilty as charged. Guilty as charged. I'm here to tell you that we have a cancer growing in this country. And it is called debt. And unless we excise it, radiate it, or cut it out, it's going to consume this young generation over here. And I'm here to tell you, for the first time in the history of this country, the greatest country that ever was, we're about to pass down to their generation a country that is less good, less productive, less competitive, less compassionate, less hopeful than the country we got. And I say that's totally unacceptable. And it's a totally, thank you. And it's a totally unnatural position for Americans to be in. We are hopeful. We are optimistic. We are problem-solving people. To be down our luck and to be in a funk like we are today is not American. Now, I come here with a couple of great people. The thing I'm most proud of in life, I married a Floridian. So, they say, I know you're looking at her saying, how did that dweeb ever land that beautiful? I know, I can hear you. So, how do you win Florida? Well, you marry a girl from Orlando to start with. I met her in high school. She had this exotic southern accent, and in public schools in Salt Lake City back in the 1970s, that southern exotic accent was really exotic, and it was about the prettiest thing I'd heard and seen. Took me years before I got a date with her. It worked out. We've got seven kids. Orlando and our new son-in-law is from Tampa. So, they say, if you own the I-4 corridor, you get it. You own Florida. If you own Florida, you own the nomination. You get the nomination in 2012, you're going to win the presidency. So it all starts here, and we hope that you're with us. During the pledge, I was reminded of the greatest generation, because I've been before some members of the greatest generation, and I think we have some here with us today. I've been in VFW posts. I've been in front of our veterans groups. We love our troops. I'm here to tell you, we have another greatest generation coming up another generation. And they too are wearing the uniform of the United States of America. And they're coming back after 10 years of conflict. They deserve respect. They deserve the very best. Our family's invested in that cause. Let me tell you that 10 years at war, I'm here to tell you that's a long time. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to rebuild our home. It's time to do a little nation building on the home front. So when you walk out of this room, I don't want anyone scratching their head saying, we saw Huntsman, we heard Huntsman, but I can't quite remember what it was all about. I want you to know why I'm in this race. Why would a perfectly normal, sane, clear-minded human being want to run for President of the United States? You got it. You got it. So I wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning, and I turn over to Mary Kay, and I say, this is insane. You know, we have 7 kids. We have a perfectly decent track record in public service. We've got a target on our back constantly now that we're a candidate. Why? And she said, shut up. Husband, governor, whatever they call you. She said, that's the logical side of your brain speaking to you. We all have the logical side of your brain. But we also have the patriotic side. And the patriotic side says, you love this country. It is the greatest country that ever was. And we all have a choice in this room. You can either stand on the sideline, kind of watch it all play out, as if it's okay to see the end of the American century. I never thought I'd be standing in front of a group in Florida talking about the prospects of the end of the American century, and here we are. You can stand on the sidelines, or you can get in the arena, as Teddy Roosevelt used to talk about, and here we are. And I know it's going to be tough. I know it's going to be grueling and excruciating at times, but we're here because we love this country, and we know that you are too. I am running, and my family is with us 110% because we find it totally, totally unacceptable that this great nation, the greatest nation that ever was, 1960, the year I was born, $3 exported for every $2 imported. We own 37% of the world's GDP. We own science, technology, the best standard of living the world had ever known. And we're about ready to pass on this country to the next generation less good than the one we got. And I find that totally, totally unacceptable. So what are we going to do about it? Three things that I want you to remember, because they're the three things that I'm going to fight every day for.